Hello, I'm Nathan Drendel, ProMedica's wellness dietitian. We're back again today for another healthy cooking demo featuring a new recipe. There's nothing better than having a nice filling burrito, in my opinion. The problem with most burritos are that they're full of calorie dense items and low in nutritious items. But today, that's going to change. Today, we'll whip up a recipe that is not only good for you, but you and your family will enjoy it. The recipe is full of fiber, lean protein, and vegetables. Perfect for a quick weeknight meal. For this burrito, we're gonna need 8 ounces of lean beef. I'm using sirloin, or you can use chicken, some seasonings to season the meat, a 1/2 cup plain fat-free Greek yogurt, 1/4 cup of fat-free ranch dressing, 1/4 teaspoon garlic powder, 1/8 teaspoon of chili powder. If you want a little bit more zip, you can be a little more liberal on the chili powder. 1/4 teaspoon of ground cumin, 3/4 cup of kidney beans, 1/2 cup of shredded sweet potatoes, 1/4 cup of diced green onions, 3/4 cup of chopped broccoli, 1/2 cup of diced Roma tomatoes, 1 to 3 teaspoons of sliced jalapeno peppers, depending again on how spicy you want it, some high fiber wraps, 4 of them, because this recipe makes 4 servings, and 1/2 cup of Monterey Jack cheese. The first step for this recipe, we're going to slice our beef into small bite-sized chunks. Many people feel that consuming beef is not very healthy for you, but in all actuality, there are many cuts of beef that can be very healthy. These cuts consist of eye or top and bottom round, top sirloin, and sirloin tip side steaks, just to name a few. Although slightly higher in fat than skinless chicken breast, the beef choices provide an excellent source of iron and zinc. Now that I have our sirloin chopped up, we're gonna put it over a medium to medium high heat in a small saute pan until it's cooked thoroughly. And I'm just gonna season the beef with a little bit of onion powder and a little bit of garlic powder. For beef, pork, and lamb, the USDA recommends an internal temperature of 145 degrees to minimize the risk of foodborne illness, while they recommend all poultry items reach 165 degrees. Using a cooking thermometer is the most accurate way to make sure these temperatures are met. I slice the beef up small enough so I don't need to use a cooking thermometer, but if you use a chicken breast or even a steak for another recipe, make sure you use a meat thermometer so you reach those temperatures. Now that I got the meat cooking, you gotta make sure you wash your hands, clean your cutting board, or get a new cutting board, and make sure you don't use the same knife. Whenever you have raw meat, whether it be beef or chicken or any poultry, make sure you do these steps to help limit foodborne illness. Now we're gonna first dice up our onions. Onions obviously have a very potent aroma. The aroma is due to 4 basic sulfur-containing compounds in the onions. Onions also are a good source of the flavonoid quercetin, which has been shown in a University of Maryland Medical Center study to neutralize free radicals and may actually help protect against damage from LDL cholesterol, thus reducing the risk of heart disease. I have the green onions chopped up. Now we're going to chop up the broccoli. We need 3/4 cup of chopped broccoli. And you don't have to finely chop it, just make it bite-sized pieces so you don't have a huge chunk of broccoli when you bite into the burrito. Broccoli is touted by many as one, if not the best food you can eat. Broccoli is very low in calories and also full of healthy compounds. Sulforaphane is one of those phytochemicals that shows the most promise for reducing cancer risk, blood pressure, and even cholesterol. Besides broccoli, sulforaphane is found in cauliflower, cabbage, and kale, but is found in highest concentrations in broccoli sprouts. Now that I have the broccoli chopped up, we're gonna dice some tomatoes and try to remove some of the liquid so it doesn't get too liquidy inside the recipe. Other than being a great source of lycopene, the other big discussion concerning tomatoes is, are they a fruit or a vegetable? Well, tomatoes are actually fruits, and they actually count as berries, but we typically view them as vegetables because they aren't typically as sweet as most fruits, but they count as fruits. Now that I diced the tomatoes, the next step is to shred the sweet potato, which I have already done. Sweet potatoes, with their bright orange color, are full of vitamin A and beta carotene, which is a natural precursor to vitamin A. These compounds actually contain retinol and retinoic acid, two extracts that are typically found in expensive skincare products. Making sure you consume enough vitamin A and beta-carotene rich foods can actually keep your skin healthy. Now that we have the four other ingredients diced up, we're gonna dice up the jalapeno peppers. There is emerging research that a chemical found in peppers, like jalapenos, called capsaicin, can have a positive impact on our metabolism. Now the studies show a slight increase, roughly around 3 to 4% increase in an individual's metabolism, which won't cancel out overeating, but over time can help shed some weight as part of a healthy diet. We have our veggies chopped. I'm gonna take the meat off the burner and just set it aside. It's thoroughly cooked. And the next step is to make our sauce. In a large mixing bowl, combine the Greek yogurt, ranch dressing, garlic powder, chili powder, and cumin. Make sure you mix it well. Greek yogurt is strained yogurt. If you've never used it before, it is thicker and creamier than regular yogurt, but also a tad more bitter than regular yogurt. The benefit of using Greek yogurt is that it is more concentrated in protein than regular yogurt, while also being very versatile, with the texture being creamier than regular yogurt. With the ranch dressing, typically I don't advise people to go to the fat-free version when they use them for salads, because a lot of the time the fat is replaced with added sugar. So choosing a low-fat dressing for salads would be my choice. But for this recipe, using the fat-free ranch coupled with the Greek yogurt allows for a nice creamy texture in the dressing, so you don't need that extra fat. Now that our sauce is mixed up, in a separate mixing bowl, mix the kidney beans, sweet potatoes, tomatoes, broccoli, green onions, and jalapeno peppers. With the spices used in this recipe, it does have a little kick. So if you aren't a big fan of spicy foods, I would keep the jalapenos to a minimum, about the 1 teaspoon mark. But if you like me and like to have a little more bite, feel free to use a couple extra teaspoons of them. We have the three main items in this recipe all complete: the dressing, the vegetable mixture, and the meat. We're gonna first add the vegetable mixture to the dressing and toss to coat. Make sure you get everything out of the bowl and give it a nice quick stir in. And by this time, your meat mixture should be cooled, so it won't make the mixture warm. Now that's all mixed up well, and we'll add the meat. And again, we'll just give it a quick little toss to mix it all in. Next up, take your tortilla, take about a 2/3 cup serving of your mixture. Remember, this makes 4 servings, so eyeball it to 4 servings. And then take a 2 tablespoon amount of the cheese. Now you may have noticed I didn't use low-fat cheese. Coming from Wisconsin, I'm a firm believer in wholesome dairy, but if you continually make a less healthy choice by picking whole dairy, as in milk, cheese, and other dairy products, a lot of the calories you are consuming are coming from saturated fat, which is the heart-clogging fat. Switching the majority of your dairy to low-fat sources is the best choice. It cuts down on calories, saturated fat, while still providing the calcium and protein that dairy products are known for. With this recipe, I use full-fat cheese because overall the recipe is low in fat and each burrito only uses about 1/2 serving. These tortillas that we are using are excellent. Not only can you find ones this size for around 80 to 110 calories, but they're great and rich in fiber, which will help make you full, quicker, and longer. Just a simple way to help with weight control. Now that the burrito is assembled, it's time for the most important part, the taste test. Delicious. The spices used allow for a great flavor. There's a crunch from the raw vegetables and a nice creamy texture from the yogurt ranch mixture. The fiber in this recipe is great. You get roughly 16 grams in one serving, which is 60% of what women need daily and about 40% of what men need. Again, my name is Nathan Drendel, ProMedica's wellness dietitian, where it's our mission to improve your health and well-being.